woman is hard work, right? But someone's got to do it. Hence the show CT Divas, where I present you some of your favorite female videos, and we also get to talk about some female issues. Now, I don't only do this by myself. I always have a guest with me, and this week I've got Emma Nyra. That's my home girl. How are you doing?
Hey, honey, I'm good.
Oh, it's so good to have you on the show, and you're welcome to the show.
Finally.
Yes, yes. We've been talking about this for a while. Now, I know that a couple of you guys might be wondering what we might be talking on. We've got several issues on today's episode of City Divas. We're talking about same sex, we're talking about being a female in the industry, and a couple other stuff. Don't go anywhere, as City Divas starts now. We're just starting out on the show, and guess who I've got with me? My home girl, Emma Nyra. And together we'll be talking about some of our female issues like I always do on the show. Now for this week, it is kind of complicated because in recent times I noticed that a lot of young stars and a lot of young people, guys or girls, happen to engage in, you know what I mean?
Some
yes,
in some 14-year activity.
Yes, some 14-year stuff. And then it's kind of, I mean, I don't want to sound like I am stereotyping people when I say that you're either homosexual or you're lesbians. But then you realize that these are serious issues that are going on around us. And it is kind of difficult to understand here in Africa because we're Africans. But then what's your take on it?
I think my take on, you know, sexuality in Nigeria, I feel like, you know, there are actually federal laws preventing people from engaging in same-sex activity, which, you know, in a way, I feel as though if somebody feels like they're born some way or they feel as if they want to try something, if you're telling a person that classifies themselves as gay, you're telling them that if you are gay, there's a punishment. It kind of hides, if I am a straight person, I'm looking for a straight person, the person might be gay. And I might be engaging with someone who is too scared to live their life. So I feel as like God gives us a choice. If you as a human choose to do something, you can do it. God gave you the choice. So you will have to answer to God. But I don't feel like, you know, as a human being, I should tell somebody, oh, you must date this person or you must
Be
like that. Because I feel like it leads to dishonesty. There's plenty of men and women who are living in fear of being who they feel like they are. I'm not saying anybody is born heterosexual, born homosexual, but as far as you as a human being, you've decided to be one way. You know, abroad, you see people who are gay, they do their own thing, and then people that are same-sex do their own thing, but if they're living in fear, then there's so much dishonesty. You can marry a man, and for 15 years,
and
you won't
know.
He'll still be engaging in that interactivity, and you won't know. So I feel like it's not fair to tell somebody by law that they can't do something. I don't agree with that.
I don't agree with it either, because I know that people, I mean, what that can do is it can also break you, not just keep you dishonest and all of that. But then, you know, it's so funny how some people say that they were born in a man's skin, whereas they should be a woman.
Yeah, a lot of people.
I wouldn't know because I'm not like that. But then that kind of makes me laugh. I find that quite hilarious. Yeah. But then, yes, we'll be talking more on these sort of stuff. But in the meantime, guys, don't go anywhere. Let's enjoy the very first video. This is Ciara and Nicki Minaj. I'm out.
Ladies, it's your song, so as soon as this come out, you should get out on the floor, go and get your sexy on. If you know that you better than a new girl daddy on, go ahead and tell them now, you gon' miss me when I'm gone.
So yes, still back on the show, CC Divas. We've only gone one notch, like we've not gone so far. So in case you're missing out on anything, we've just been talking about same sex and all of that, and relationships like that. Now, have you ever been approached by any female?
Oh my gosh, at one of my shows, I even remember her name, I'm not gonna say it, there was this girl. She just said she liked me, that she wanted my number, that she likes my music. I was like, okay, fine, I chat with people all the time. Wow, this girl called me and she was like, you know, I really like you, I love you. And I was like, you love me?
Yeah.
I was like, what do you mean? She was like, I really think you're beautiful. And she approached, her style was like a guy. So I was like,
all right. So you're like, oh.
Like, she was like, I don't mind if you don't like girls or anything, but let's just hang out, let's chill. And I was like, hold on.
Don't even watch me like that.
I just politely declined, but yeah. She was aggressive. I still see her out every now and then. Very nice girl, but yeah. it was an experience. Oh, yeah.
I can imagine. I've had my own experiences too. Yeah. I wouldn't lie. And somehow it actually affects the way you relate with people. Yes. It totally does. I don't want to relate like that, but I just feel that, okay, when I see a certain person and we're not so close yet, but then you're getting a little too, I'm like, because I don't want to come across as rude or anything like that. So I just try to keep it, you know, keep
but
it
But I
safe.
Think they understand. If they you're do, not right? aggressively that way, then they'll, like, I don't think there's any hard feelings if you're like, you know what?
No, yeah, yeah. I haven't had anyone who has actually quarreled with me or fought with me because I said no. But it has just created a bit of strain. So where I'm like, I don't want to be in that
no
space.
No misunderstanding.
You know what I mean? But yes, in recent times, like, I know that I've touched this issue earlier. I think that was a couple weeks ago. I actually touched this issue. And it is about having females, just like in the Western world where you have some other artists and in their music videos they have two females kissing,
engaging
and all of that. Well, it has kind of come to Nigeria where it is seen that in some artists like Native C's LLA and I think Sorry for the Gods, there was a part of the video where there were two females kissing, right? Now, I understand that this is not trying to discriminate or try to be like, okay, they're not these type of people as well. Mm-hmm. But then what's your take on it? I mean, like we said earlier, this is Africa and we have beliefs, we have some, we're quiet, you know?
Mm-hmm. I think that it's a touchy subject because you have to be careful how you influence the youth with your music.
Yeah.
I feel like as an adult, you can make whatever decision you want to make, but we as musicians, we have the responsibility of affecting the youth.
Yeah.
So if I'm a young girl and I'm watching a Nato C or a Flavor video, and I like those artists, if I see two girls kissing, it's a part of the norm. You understand?
Cool, yeah.
So, you know, not to be judgmental, but I feel like all of that should wait until a person is older, you know, making wiser decisions, whether you want to choose one thing or choose another. But it's delicate when you're talking about music because music affects the youth. It affects people who are happy, sad, and that's when you're most vulnerable.
Yeah.
You understand? So it's very touchy. It's a touchy subject. Also, in Sam Smith's new video, very controversial.
Yes, as well.
You know, so it's very, very rampant right now. But I feel as though I think there might be a high level of, you know, people who are not being able to be themselves.
Yeah.
So I feel like you should allow people, just like I said earlier, allow them to be themselves, express themselves how they want to.
I totally agree with you because I know that a lot of kids these days, or even adults, are so influenced by whoever's around them. Mm-hmm. I mean, you don't have your own self, you know, you don't have your own individual self, generally speaking. So if you see a video like that and you're like, oh, I actually like this artist, I mean, you're like, oh, this is so cool. Just as there are so many Wiz kids, there's so many Davidos, there's so many Tiwa,
like,
and all
who you
that.
Aspire
so,
to
yeah,
be.
Exactly. So I know that actually does affect these things. But then I think that here, back home in Africa, since we're not that exposed in that sense, you know what I mean? We should try to contain it a little bit and not go over the top. But in the meantime, let's move further and enjoy more videos. This is Rihanna, though. This is a piece that during my NYC was like a big deal. When I say a big deal, I mean that everyone was singing it and playing it all over the place. And my flatmates were always jumping every time this song came on. I'm talking about Rihanna featuring Drake with What's My Name.
Oh, na, na. What's my name? Oh, na. What's my name?
Heard you good with them soft lips. Yeah, you know word of mouth. The square root of 69 is 8 something, right? Cause I've been trying to work it out. Ah, good.